To set up a data integration, begin by opening Data Exchange on the homepage. Before you create and run data integrations, you must register source and target applications, define period mappings to map source system period names and keys to financial consolidation and close periods and years, and define category mappings to categorize and map source system data to a target scenario dimension member. Let's create the data integration. The Create Integration page identifies the four process steps you must complete to create the integration. On the General page, enter a name and an optional description. For location, you can select an existing location or create a location. I'll create a location. For source, you have the option to select a source application or a file. This example shows file and FCC as sources, but there are many other source types you can use, such as Fusion General Ledger and Subledgers, NetSuite, on-premise data warehouses, cloud databases, and so forth. For this example, I'll select File to load this trial balance report file. In File Browser, verify that you are in the Inbox folder and click Upload. Navigate to the file location and click Open. Select the file and click OK. The file is now associated with the source. Click File Options. Set and verify the file options and click Next. View a subset of the data to be loaded and click Finish. For target, select the FCC application. Set or verify the cube and category. Click Save and Continue to navigate to the Map Dimensions page. Set or verify your import settings. The next step is to map source dimensions to target dimensions. You can use expressions instead of member mappings to define simple data transformations. For large data sets, using expressions can improve data load performance. Click Save and Continue to open the Map Members page, where you can map source system members for each dimension to their corresponding target members. Note, if you have defined target expressions to derive the target members for a given dimension, then you do not have to define member mappings. Begin by selecting a dimension and clicking Add to open the Add Member Mapping dialog. Select the member mapping type from the Mapping Type dropdown, and then specify the source and target values. In this example, I'll use an explicit mapping to map a source entity to a target entity. The mapping for entity is displayed. Repeat the process to map members for all dimensions. Note that some mappings are system generated. Click Save and Continue to open the Options page. Use Options to define general options for period processing, filters for importing data for non-file sources, and options on how to process the data when loading to the target application. I'll accept the default selections. Click Save and Close to return to the integration page. Now, we're ready to run the integration. Select the import and export modes, the start and end period, and run the integration. Wait for the integration to complete. You have the options to download the log file and open the workbench. Open the workbench to confirm the data was loaded. The workbench provides a point-of-view framework to import, view, verify, and load data from your source. I can verify that the explicit member mapping I created is correct. Close the workbench to return to the data integration page. The icon shows the integration was successful. You can use the Actions menu to modify the integration or return to the workbench. Open an FCC form to verify that the data was loaded. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.